Cooper Webb, and I choose OGO.
I'm Christian Craig.
I'm Dean Wilson.
I'm Aaron Plessinger.
I'm Jerry Martin.
I'm Nate Thrasher.
I'm Shane McElrath.
I'm Hunter Lawrence.
My name's Jet Lawrence.
I'm Jordan Smith.
I'm Talon Hawkins.
Stargate Hampshire.
I'm Hayden Deegan.
I'm Colt Nichols.
And I choose OGO.
And I choose OGO.
And I choose OGO.
I'm Tom Vialle. I choose OGO.
And I choose OGO.
And I choose OGO.
I'm Julien Beamer. And I choose OGO.
I was pretty good. 11-9 for ninth overall, so I'm happy. We had a goal of top 10, 5-10, so we got that, so I'm happy.
Okay, you did have a hard concrete goal coming in up to top 10, so that's good.
Yeah.
What was the motos like? 230-minute motos, a red flag? I mean, you got it all today.
Yeah, we had pretty much, you could say, three motos today. We had three starts, so that was definitely a different thing. I think that's the first time they've even done that, so that was pretty cool, and yeah, it was good. Definitely surprised with the pace. You have to push for 30 plus two, which you don't get that much at home. So that was new to me, but I felt good.
What did you think of the way the track broke down? I mean, this has got to be way different than 65cc bumps and peewee bumps that you rode at the ranch.
Yeah, for sure. The track definitely, I feel like the track is better in areas. It's definitely a lot more smooth, like the ruts aren't as notchy. But the track was gnarly today. They made it deep, so it was a gnarly track.
Yeah, day was pretty good, actually. For sure, not the result I want to. I want to be up there in the podium, but I missed it for a few points. But I feel like I had a red flag. I was third, and then they restarted the motor. I had a great overshot, and unfortunately, like Deegan hit me from the back, and I almost crashed. He crashed, and I was really close to crash. So I was happy to not crash, and I came back fifth. So second moto, the start, I lost a little bit the balance out of the gate, and wasn't a really good start, and I came back to six, and I feel overall we made some change on the fog this week, and I was happy with that. Bike was working really good, and really looking forward for the next one. I want to be up there on the podium for sure for the next one, so that will be the goal. Have a good week of training, and let's do it for the next one.
What was that red flag like to begin middle of the moto, your heart rate maximum, and then you have to go sit there in the sun on the line for 15 minutes?
I mean, when was a red flag, I was sure that we're going to restart like 1, 2, 3, 4. I was like, okay, that's not bad, you know. But when they said like we're going to do another start, I was a little bit worried. And actually, I had a great start, a little bit like in the sand, like Southwick. I went out of the gates really fast, and I was first. So I was feeling good, actually, before the red flag. I was in third. I was really next to Joe, and Hunter was behind me, and we had a gap of 10 seconds, I think, on the fifth guy, so I would have been changing the overall maybe a little bit if we were staying before the red flag, but yeah, for sure not the result I won, but that day went to the good way, I think.
All right, last thing, most important question, another track for you to check off. What do you think?
Track was nice. I enjoyed that track. Was rough, technical, feel like a lot of camber, and was pretty nice. I enjoyed the track. I'm sure that if I ride again another time, or maybe next year for sure, I will be better. The thing is, I will know how the track develop, and I don't really know. I go to each moto, and it gets really dry some part, and some part muddy still and soft, and yeah, let's see. I'm excited for next year already, and coming back to this track, and that one I really enjoy it, actually.
Yeah, do you like that dirt?
Yeah, it was a little bit like, not sandy, of course, but not hard. It was a mix between, and was pretty cool. I like it a lot, the track.
It was okay. First moto was really good, 10. Second moto was really good, 10th for about two laps ago, and then Ferenis came through and passed Freddie and I, and I went 10-11 for, I think, 10th maybe, so it was an okay day. I felt good. Fitness is coming around. Speed's coming around. So got some flight.
Yeah, I mean, watching it today, first through 40th was a dogfight. You guys, everybody was right there. And even when you were lapping dudes, you were coming up on a pack of lappers that are battling position.
Yeah, the lappers weren't very nice. You know, I couldn't imagine the top guys that were actually trying to battle for, you know, podium spot. So I'm battling for a top 10 and lappers are struggling with me, you know. So it is what it is. But I mean, that's a part of racing, and the track personally sucked today. Super hard pack. I don't know. It was one line. You know, I wasn't going fast enough from the guys in front of me to make a couple passes. So it is what it is. But I'm happy to get two consecutive motos. Looking forward to Ironman and just enjoying the outdoor grind.
I think it's been drier up here because it didn't seem like it had that bottomless just muck.
Yeah, it didn't. It didn't have any. I don't know where the topsoil went. Like the old finish line, and I don't know. Even after Henry Hill, like it was so hard packed, it felt like ice. It could barely crack the throttle on a 450, or else you were doing a 360. So, I don't know. I know they tried ripping it and tried watering it for practice, but I think it just made it. It was too much to where we couldn't move around, and the berms were too deep. You couldn't really get any drive. So, it's a catch 22. I don't really know how you go about it, but definitely needs a little more topsoil ripped in with the hard pack dirt. So,
okay, last thing, because you've ridden here so much over the years, walking around it, it looked like some corners were made more narrow and some things got just kind of brought around. After riding here so many times and so many different iterations, how much do you notice subtle changes like that?
Yeah, I even said on press day, I'm like, man, I don't know, the track's looking more narrow now than it has ever. So I don't really know. I know Millville struggles with it because when you're on the hillside, you know, you get runoff and everything like that, so you lose a lot of the track. So I don't know if they need to go back in on some of the hillsides and kind of push everything back with the erosion and whatnot, but I'm not a track guy, so I don't know. I just ride it, but I just know it was very narrow and it was just hard for us to move around and try and pivot around. So it's more slot car racing than anything. So we'll see how it turns out for next year.
Good day. Results didn't really show it, but really good two motos. Didn't really get tired or anything. Good, but first moto, I got a pretty good start and then got hit from the outside, and then I went back to like mid pack or so, and then worked my way up to eighth. And by the time I got up to eighth, those top guys were gone. I closed the gap a little bit, but lap times were really good in both motos, right up there with the top guys. And then second moto, pretty good start, and then I was just trying everything to pass and just really struggle with the passing, but two really good motos, consistent, and somehow I went 8-7 for ninth overall. Not sure how it works, but that's kind of the normal for me this year. But it's a good day. The results didn't really show up, but yeah.
Dude, that second moto, you had your hooks in Jason and Adam. Like, I was wow, Cowie.
Yeah, I was doing everything I could, but it was hard. I feel like straightaways kind of get gapped a little bit, and then it was super hard to pass and make a move, and I was trying everything, and I was eating a lot of roost, but yeah.
You've been to this track before?
Yeah.
Okay. Mm-hmm. What do you think about it today, riding it, especially on the big bike? A little bit drier, a little bit faster, a couple track changes, stuff like that.
Yeah, it was pretty good. It was weird. It was all the water was on top, and then it was super hard packed base. It was kind of like, it was deep, but it wasn't that deep. It was just kind of sloppy on top and then just concrete underneath. But I feel like it was pretty sloppy in the morning and kind of made it one line. Everything just kind of pushed in. But track's pretty cool here. Definitely a hard one to pass, but no, the track's really fun. But it was a good one.
It was a pretty solid day. I think I went 6-8, 6-7 on the day. Pretty solid on my starts. Super happy with my starts now. Had two weekends back-to-back with top 10 starts. Speed's been there. You know, first moto, I battled with the top five guys the whole time. Just couldn't quite get in the fifth position like I was wanting, but still a solid day to come out with, I think, a seventh overall.
How'd that feel, especially first moto? I mean, the pack is right there. You're going for it, and dude, those last 10 minutes were a dogfight because everybody was just trading spots, going through lappers, everything.
Yeah, no, it was definitely fun. Definitely feel like I had the pace to be up there with those guys. Sadly, the last 4.5 laps, I ran out of tear-offs. We had a little bit of an issue with my tear-offs midway through, and I went to pull one. Nothing was coming off, and then I yanked it, and I think half my tear-offs came off. So at that point, it was just salvaging my tear-offs and just trying to stay in there, but I feel like if I would have had more tear-offs than the moto, I definitely would have been hopefully fifth or fourth.
Hi, Garrett. We're one race away from the end of this. Summer's been pretty good. You know, highs and lows. You guys have learned a new bike. You've made a lot of adjustments. How's it feel?
We've made a lot of progress with the bike through the year. Heck, I'd say personally this is the best round I've had on the bike. Even though second moto I wasn't really gelling 100%, I don't think you're always going to in both motos of the track. It's very rare. But I'd definitely say today was the best I've ever felt on the bike, and in a race situation, I felt very comfortable.
A lot better than last weekend in Unadilla. Yeah, we used today more like testing. We tested brand new suspension on press day, and then after press day, we talked a lot, and we put on some new forks for practice today, and it was good. I felt comfortable, and we changed things throughout the day, and we made progress throughout the day, and had a good battle with AP second moto. Kind of battled all day, which was cool. I would say my weakness right now is my strength, upper body. My fitness feels good, but I just, you know, a little chicken body right now. Don't got the muscle I need. So, yeah, but other than that, though, it was a nice day. I love Budds Creek. Track was rough, ruddy, bumpy. Yeah, two good starts. I was stoked on that. Me and Sorby have been working hard on that, so we're making progress.
Is that Unadilla worst cars all over you still?
No,
that's today. Damn.
Yeah, Russo was no joke. Luckily, my crew at A-Stars got me a chest protector covering my collarbone, so it doesn't get the roost, but everywhere else gets the roost still. So, yeah, today was a good roost, a lot of it. A lot of started up front, got passed by a few guys, held on, but yeah, it was good. I was happy. Obviously, second moto, I would have liked to beat AP, so I would have got podium position, but it's all good. Yeah, I told AP I'll let it slide this time.
I can't wait to rewatch some of these motos from today because it was a battle. It was nuts.
Yeah, I feel like I was kind of in a battle when I got past. I'd latch on, learn some stuff. And so, yeah, I think the racing was probably really good today. Hopefully the TV crew was on their game with the cameras. And, yeah, I think all in all it was a productive day. And like I've been saying, our goal is super motocross. So if we could have a day like today in Indiana and just build and stay healthy and safe and just progress through some motocross.
Okay, last thing. You've been burning some calories today. I know you're on it, you know, the feed and all that. What do you guys do to recoup at the end of the night? Like, is it full? Like, what's in the black
stove? Amber's got the pasta cooking inside. Got some sauce. We got a whole bunch of chicken. I'm going to have some asparagus? Come on. Sorry. Asparagus? New York's not so good at saying that. But, yeah, just eat a whole bunch of food as much as I can. And, yeah. That's really it.
Day in the life.